Hey, we got a good one. Okay. Why am I talking so fast? Anyway, today we're doing custom layouts. Yeah, custom layouts. So let's go ahead and get into it right now. Now that you understand layouts, let's go ahead and create our own custom layout that you can create to accommodate your workflow. Okay. So first thing we can do is let's say I pull out this brush settings palette. I could pull it off to the side. I can put it anywhere I want. I can come over here and put it within this frame. You'll see the blue line around the whole thing, that square. That means it's going to allow me to drop within that section. I can also take this, pull it out, and notice there's just a blue line. If I let go, what that's going to do is stack it in between. Okay. Now let's say I might want to try pulling up, let's say, the navigator. Okay. So let's say I have a navigator here. Maybe I don't want it up top. I want to pull this down to the bottom corner. Now, what I'm essentially doing here is just rearranging this whole layout, and then I'm going to save it. So this is something that I would be able to come back to time and time again. So if we go up to the top to that same section and we click here, we can scroll down and we can go to new workspace. Okay. So if we go to new workspace, what this is going to do is allow us to save, and I'm just going to call it Revels Test. Now, here's something that's important where it says capture. If you create custom keyboard shortcuts, you change menu commands, toolbar, which I'm going to discuss in the very next module. If you make adjustments to all of these things and you want to make sure that these things stay with the workspace, you must make sure these are checked, because if you don't have them checked, when you go to that workspace, you're going to lose all the customization for those items that are there. Okay, so you want to make sure those are checked. I just do it by default from here because I made the mistake not doing that early on, and I would lose a lot of my customization and I would have to redo everything. So if I hit save, you'll now see that if we come up here, you'll see it's saved inside. So I have Revels Test. I have some of my older versions of layouts. Okay. You'll see I have layouts for my Cintiq. I have Revels 2018. So if I click on this, sit here and hit reset Revels. And there we go. Now it's Revels 2018 and it's reset back to the base default. Let's go back to the Revels test and you'll see that it toggles back to the layout that I had. So essentially, you can set up various different types of layouts for different workflows that you're going to be doing. I highly recommend this because each one of us is unique and different. And some of us are left-handed, some are right-handed. You may want to accommodate everything to be sitting on your power hand, especially if you're using a Cintiq. It'll really make a big difference. Versus having to take your hand and cross over your body constantly, your hand is going to cover a lot of the menus, and that's just going to become really is going to be annoying after a while. If you're using just a normal Wacom tablet, you can use you won't have that issue with your hand covering. But anyway, this is what you're essentially looking for in terms of for creating a custom layout. Now let's just show you one last little part here. Let's clean it up where, let's say I have a bunch of old layouts in here that I don't need anymore. If I go down to delete workspace, I can navigate. So let's say Revels 2016. I don't want that. I hit delete. Am I sure? Yes. Let's say I come in here again. I'm going to delete workspace. This time I'm going to jump down to test T. Don't want that. Let's get rid of this. Just simple housekeeping. So delete. if I don't want the Revels test, well, actually that's active, so I would actually have to switch to a different one. But let's just say I don't want the Revels iMac 2016. Let's go ahead and get rid of that. So I go ahead and hit delete. And then, for example, if I needed to get rid of the Revels test, let's just go ahead and switch over to Revels 2018. And then once you're in Revels 2018, go ahead, come down and hit delete workspace. And now you will be able to have access to the Revels test. Now you can go ahead and hit delete and it should work fine for you. So there you go. So that's how you can clean up the workspaces. If you have a bunch of them in there that you don't need, you start to make this a simpler list for yourself, and that's it. Okay, so that's it. Let's just go ahead and jump on to the next module. Okay, if you enjoyed that, please hit subscribe and the notification button. That's the little bell button below. Also, please go check out digitalpaintingtips.com. Okay, over there I have some brushes and things like that. They're going to be available for people who want to dive deeper into this. So don't hesitate. Go check it out.